We are now joined by Madam Fu Ying. Madam Fu Ying is chairwoman of the Foreign Affairs Committee of the Chinese National People's Congress. Warm welcome. In March, China underwent its once-in-a-decade leadership change. Which are your top priorities as chairwoman of the Foreign Affairs Committee of the Chinese National People's Congress?
Thank you for having me here. First, it's really an honor to be invited to attend this Gallen Symposium. I really enjoyed it. For your question, the National People's Congress of China, NPC in short form, has a very important responsibility of building the rule of law and upholding the rule of law. So the 12th National People's Congress will be building based on what has been achieved in the past. On that basis, we'll continue to build more laws and rules. You know, in China, it was only in 2010 we announced the completion of building a structure of the law in China, covering most of the areas, economic, social areas. But it's not the end. It's not sufficient. So we'll have to continue to build, make more laws. And more importantly, we should make sure that laws are implemented, properly enforced. So that will be the main task Foreign Affairs Committee. In addition to legislative work, we also want to extend our contact with our counterpart in other countries to build understanding.
Madam Fu Ying, in Western media, China is mostly criticized for its human rights situation. What is your opinion on this, and how will you tackle this task?
There is definitely room for improvement in human rights area in China, in spite of the tremendous progress we've made over the past decades. China's population is one-fifth of the whole world. And the good news is that in China, starvation, hunger is no longer the problem. And the employment, especially for the young people, is generally sufficient. And yet, there is a lot to be desired, so there's a lot to be done.
Coming to the last question, you held a work session entitled, "What is the Chinese Dream About?" Do you think the Chinese dream coincides with the one of the rest of the world?
The Chinese dream, in essence, is very simple and basic. It's really for the families to be happy, for the young generation to be fulfilled, and for the elderly, the sick, cared for. So these are the basic needs. I'm quite sure it's widely shared in the world. But in China, we believe that the prosperity of the country, the success of the country, will provide the room for the individuals to be successful, to fulfill their dreams, and to have the, as your slogan says, to have the courage be rewarded. In turn, the success of individuals will add to the success of the country. So it's a combination. The Chinese dream is it means a combination of the success of the country and the possibility of success of individuals. When China is trying to achieve that aim, we're quite sure it will create lots of more opportunities to the world. So it's a process we work together with the world.
Madam Fu Ying, thank you very much for granting us some of your time. Enjoy your stay at the 43rd Gallen Symposium. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.